Delayed implementation of the project has affected delivery of health services in facilities.
The chairperson of the Parliament's Health Committee, Dr. Charles Ayume, presented a report before Parliament on the investigations into a dispute between the Ministry of Health and the BMK Constructions over the untimely construction of maternity health units in selected districts across the North and West Nile areas by BMK. The report indicated that the failure for BMK to complete construction of 14 maternity wards was due to COVID-19 restrictions.
Therefore, the committee recommends that BMK is given an opportunity to complete the works. Since BMK has expressed renewed capacity and has procured building materials and deployed personnel on ground,
the committee went on to recommend Parliament to cause a meeting between the Minister of Health, Attorney General and BMK Constructions to see how the contract terms can be renegotiated to allow BMK to complete stalled works.
A tripartite meeting be held between Ministry of Health, BMK Limited and KK Partnership Architects in the presence of the Attorney General to discuss the legal issues surrounding this agreement and forge a way forward.
BMK Constructions was awarded a 23 billion shillings contract to construct maternity health units in 14 selected districts. But the 16 months of the contract elapsed when the contractor had executed only 60% of the works. This forced the Ministry of Health to cancel the contract on grounds of slow progress. Now, MPs demand the Ministry of Health to allow BMK to complete works before the World Bank program expires in June 2023.
I really join the committee to pray that BMK is left with this contract to do the job to the end so that the people of the West Nile can benefit from this service. Otherwise, you also run the risk of now going into other legal issues. We also run a risk of closing BMK, by the way.
MPs wondered why the ministry rushed to cancel a BMK's contract with a local firm. It has been so lenient with international contractors by granting them extensions every time they seek them.
We have companies we are giving 200 billion. We have Abubakar. Abubakar, whom we've given 50-something billion. Okay? We have Akiak, who has gotten around 270 billion. Now, this one is not even asking for money. He's saying, leave me with my small contract, and I complete.
But the Minister of State for Primary Health Care, Margaret Muhanga, insisted that BMK did not show capacity to complete works on time, which is why they terminated the contract.
After that meeting, I think everybody got out knowing that BMK doesn't have the capacity to finish the work they gave them.
However, the leader of opposition, Mathias Mpuuga, accused ministry officials for soliciting 10% kickback from the contractor, which frustrated progress of works.
That there are individuals who told the company that they have to part with 10% revolutionary fund. Whose revolution and whose fund? They are not saying, talking about it.
The Minister of General Duties, Justin Kasue Lumumba, who represented the leader of government, agreed with Parliament and promised to engage government to support the local firm BMK to finish the construction works. She expressed the need by government to support local contractors.
I think we should come up with a procedure and the principles under which who should be supported so that it is transparent and clear for everybody.
Parliament adopted the Health Committee report and gave the Minister of Health up to 10th January to report back to Parliament on the progress of the recommendation to sit with a contractor and renegotiate terms. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.